Hello! Welcome to ZEPETO Studio. I'm Kiwi, here to walk you through a studio tutorial. This time, we will use 3D modeling to create items. First, you need Unity to create items, and you'll need a 3D modeling software as well. This studio tutorial guide will explain using Maya. To modify the texture file, you'll also need a tool like Adobe Photoshop to edit images, and you can download the following files from the ZEPETO Studio homepage. If your programs are all prepared, please select which category of items you'd like to create. Let's start 3D modeling now. In this tutorial, we'll look at how to model the shape of clothes using masks. You'll be editing to create a flat pattern for coloring clothes, and texture work to color according to the UV development diagram. First, import the Creator Baseset ZEPETO file into Maya. Within the ZEPETO Creator Baseset group, there are mask object and joint files. Take the mask object and joint out of the group and delete the ZEPETO Creator Baseset file. To create the outfit more easily, make the mask an A pose with rotate Z values of shoulder L and shoulder R as -7.5 and setting the upper arm L, upper arm R rotate Z values to -40. Add top BTM dummy. Please mind the volume of top guide when creating top items and BTM guide when creating bottom items. When making bottoms, don't spill out of the top guide. And when making tops, make sure it does not pass into the BTM guide. It doesn't matter when creating a set. When making shoes, add SH guide and make shoes according to the shoes guide object. Shoes guide is the same shape as most socks that are usually made. If the shoe modeling you created does not cover the shoes guide properly, socks can stick out. Let's start creating then. First, I'll edit the top guide object to make a simple top. Please make it so that it does not pass into the BTM guide. The mask object and wireframe should be similar so that the clothes follow naturally when the character moves. After modeling the top, I'll do UV editing to color the clothes. UV is an expanded view of 3D to 2D. If you cut UV along the sewing line of the clothes and spread it out, you can easily edit UV. When the UV editing is finished, I'll make the texture according to the UV development. In this tutorial, I'll use Photoshop to edit. I'll make a texture with a gradient color and the ZEPETO logo on the front of the top. applying the texture in Maya and modify it if necessary. When you're done with the texture, disconnect the texture from Maya. Now delete the BTM guide object you no longer need. Perform rigging work on the produced top test. After rigging is complete, restore the joints from the A-shaped pose back to the T-shaped pose. Afterwards, clear the history of the mask object so that it is not affected by joint. Select the mask object and paint the vertex color. The white part of the vertex color is the part that is rendered when the character is dressed, and the black part is the part that cannot be rendered. Paint the area covered by clothes with black, and paint the parts that are not covered by clothes with white. Finally, select Joint, Mask Object, and Made Item, and export to finish your first step of your item creation. Among the categories, headwear items are produced using different masks. To create, please add Headwear Guide into Maya. After importing the file, there is a mask and joint for the headwear, a dummy face for the copy weight, and dummy hair that can be used as a reference when making headwear. First, model the headwear according to the volume of dummy hair. Here, we will quickly create a basic headband. When the modeling work is done, do UV work and texture work just like you did with the clothes. I'll simply add a white stripe to the base of the blue and purple gradient. Connect the texture in Maya to make sure it has the desired look, then disconnect again. I'll do the rigging work. Select joint and headwear modeling and bind skin. If you select the joint and adjust the scale, you can see that the dummy face and headwear move differently. In this case, the headwear will not be able to respond properly to the character's face. If you select dummy face and headwear modeling in order and do a copy weight, you can see that the headwear modeling responds and transforms to the dummy's face. Delete the dummy face and dummy hair that you don't need afterwards. Paint all the vertex colors of the mask with white and then export. And the first step in the production process of the headwear category is over. Next, we'll take a look at the second step of creating items using 3D modeling.